Welcome back, First Echo Company. This is your brigade commander reporting for duty, but it looks like today we have the company chief warrant officer with us today. That's right. Today we are going to be playing as Chief Warrant Officer Tanner Wiggins, our EOD and demolitions expert. Some would even say a master of the explosive arts. Well, when he's not blowing himself up, that is. But that's actually why we are here today. Today, I thought I'd continue our escapades with the side ops, while also continuing the mission list as well. So the next episode will be Angel with Broken Wings. We'll eventually get to that. But today we're going to do some side ops. I want to keep interjecting the side ops into here so that you guys are used to it more often, seeing gameplay of various people from First Echo and how they interact, or even people that are just within Theta Brigade itself, because it as it's all the different companies for the 1st Battalion, 2nd Battalion, 3rd Battalion, all within the same brigade. So there's going to be a lot of different people that I'm going to be playing as, with specific weapons, loadouts, all that stuff, even partners, because as of right now, we have with us, if I can zoom around, we have D-Dog with us today. How you doing, buddy? Oh, you doing so good. All right. So we are just going to jump right into it for our side ops list, and we have a good combination right here. We have a prisoner extraction right here at Dashingahek, whatever that is. And also, this one right here is a mine clearing. So it is going to be perfect to pair up. Now we're going to start over here at this landing zone. Actually, I'm going to start us off. What is this? Eliminate the heavy infantry. You know, we could technically do that. You know what? Actually, I'm going to start us off over here. I'm feeling good about this. So, Tanner uses a wide variety of weapons. Pretty much the same stuff that I would typically use. Assault rifles, shotguns, grenade launchers, DMRs, light and heavy machine guns, rocket launchers, anything like that. He is our heavy hitter, you know? I would argue, him and I are probably the closest things to a tank that we have in our group of friends. You know, you got Stevie the sniper, you got Ty the operator, you got Nicholas the infiltrator, and everything like that, which are more stealth focused, but still have some aspect. Like Ty's an operator, so he has a wider range. But yeah, we all have our lot in life, our spot in the squad, if you will. Even though it's only just a fire team, but anyway, so we're gonna be going in with what do we have? A shorty shotgun, and the ALM-48 machine gun. I was about to say light machine gun, but once we upgrade this, because you can actually see in the tree later on, it actually shows you like what upgrades you can get. This thing turns into a heavy machine gun with all the firepower. I'm going to be using this thing a lot more in the future, because it gets so darn good. Like, you can actually see the progression of it. It's just amazing. So we're gonna be taking D-Dog in, and we're gonna be going at 0600. We're gonna start, and we're gonna have this early on in the day, but we're also gonna have more daylight. I think what I'll do is, for more stealth-based operations, I will have it at nighttime. But for the sake of the stream, and so that you can see everything, I want it to be visible. So we're going to do this episode in the daytime. We're going to do the next mission in the daytime, most likely, just so you can see everything. Now, obviously, with the limitations of what weapons I can pick, because they have to balance a lot of stuff in this game for later stuff that we'll get into, I couldn't pick like a grenade launcher, an assault rifle, or anything like that. I have to be specific with what I choose. Oh, we got a dispatch mission. and it was successful. Now, we also don't have a tranquilizer. We, in fact, have a suppressed... Oh, look at that. Another... Okay, good job, guys. Good job. Check out the combat
Please
one.
Please select a mission.
Sweet. So we'll go ahead and send them out. Let's take out squad ambush surveillance cameras. We'll send them
Unit
out for that.
Dispatched.
And, night vision.
Unit dispatched.
We'll send them to take out that stuff. So the next time... And I already sent a team out to take out the helmets, so we won't have to deal with enemy combatants that show up with helmets. So, our mission right now is to do a mine clearing. A-okay. How you doing, good dog? Good dog. Good dog. Who took the puppies? Oh, a sheep.
Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated.
But where? Oh, it's over that way. We're going the wrong way. Now, because I have D-Dog, as you can see, the little indication over the sheep, that's D-Dog. See, it just said, found wild animal. It just... Oh, there it is. You see that? I'm kind of looking at it. There you go. That's more visible. He detects things within a wide range of our position. He sniffs them out. Now I don't know how they get it so that the recon team is able to tell me, hey, they're over here. But you know, it's a really cool system. I appreciate it. So taking D-Dog in with us, he'll be able to sniff out wild animals, plants, enemies, prisoners, and he'll mark them appropriately. Now I think D-Dog can also detect mines. So, I'm taking him out here with me. It's a little bit of a nerve-wracking thing because we got to clear out the mines from this main road right here. There we go. But I think the recon team has already provided us with information. Nope, they have not. We are going to have to find these on our own. Now, I think... Oh, found landmine. So then we check.
Marker
then
placed.
We can mark them.
Get
this one out of the way. Okay, so we got a wide dispersal. I kind of figured that this one was over here. Yeah, look at these bastards.
You have arrived at your destination.
Come over here. Sneak up on it. Bam. EOD at its finest. Oh, there's some more. I see him. We're just going to move on around. Now, we could destroy these, but it actually gives us more heroism. Yeah, if we dispose of it. So,
these
guys hiding them in the bushes. Not the best hiding spots, but the... Ooh, calm down, D-Dog. I see some more. Okay. There we go. Now I'm also wearing this heavy padded armor that should help out against explosives and heavy munitions for Tanner. D-Dog, can you not walk towards that, please? You're making me nervous. Bam. 5 out of 7, this would be 6. Oh! You know, D-Dog, you gotta stop. You gotta stop moving so much, buddy.
Good dog.
See, this is the one thing I don't like about having D-Dog with me is the fact that he constantly moves. Now, that was most likely my fault. I will take that L. But we can't have an episode with Tanner without him exploding. At least once. But we're good.
Psydops list updated.
Okay.
Extraction arrived at mother base.
So now, the next mission that we got... Jesus. We gotta run quite a ways. We can make it. Come on, D-Dog. Oh my god. It's hot as hell out here, although we do have some clouds. we're kind of good. Also, I'd like to point out, if you ever change cameras, like your angle, D-Dog will swap sides. Watch this. Bam. Bam. He doesn't even know where to go. Now, eventually I will be able to construct armor for D-Dog, special suit so he can do specific, orders or anything. Oh, good. That sniper rifle just completed, so that the next time we do one of these episodes, I'll be playing as Stevie. I was going to go with the bolt action for Stevie, but, I figured I should try and keep it simple. Simple and clean. I get it. This is one of the downsides of having D-Dog with you, is the fact that, and see, I didn't even change the camera. I just started running at a different angle, and so it automatically changed the camera, but D-Dog is still over there. But if I do this, bam, now he's over there. So he's not in the way of your camera. And it doesn't matter how fast you run, because you will be able to get upgrades later on for your bionic arm. He will always keep up with you, no matter what. So that's all.
Extraction arrived at mother base. Enemy presence detected.
Well, after that long stroll on the beach, let's see what we got here. Yeah, see, D-Dog will automatically notify me if there's an enemy nearby. Sniff, growl, all that kind of stuff. Now, we don't have the proper means to take down enemy combatants from a distance without alerting anybody of our presence. So, what we're going to do... Jesus, okay. What we're going to do is we're going to try our best in the middle of the day... sneak past these enemies. We're gonna sneak past, try and get our get the prisoner out of here. I believe D-Dog can sniff the prisoner. Actually detect their position. Okay, nothing yet. And of course, the farther away that things are, the longer it'll take to sniff them out, or it won't be within that certain boundary. So we're just gonna crawl our way over here. Now, oh yeah, because we picked up those mines, we have them now, but we wouldn't be EOD if we didn't have some fun with explosives. Spotted a new threat. I'm hoping a truck doesn't come through. Oh, there we go. Prisoner has been detected. Watch ourselves and be careful. Come on over. Cool. Need to watch out for that sniper. I don't think he hasn't detected us yet, but we still need to be cautious. Oh, there we go. So what we're going to do, we're going to set this here. I'm going to hope for the best that the C4 will actually cause a decent explosion. Gonna go check on some things. That's fine. Ooh boy. Don't suspect a thing. here. Oh, sweet. It's gonna happen, right? Come on. There we go. Then. Oh, why is it so fast? You don't know what's gonna happen, guys. You don't know what's gonna happen. Here's the prisoner.
Analysis.
That's the target.
Oh, hello.
Thank you.
Let me get you out of here. Just to be on the safe side. Just to be on the safe side. Get you out of here. Strap a balloon. All right, we got her out of here. Now to make our daring escape.
Okay, subject is in.
Extraction arrived at mother base.
Yeah, you heard some gunfire. How about a little bit of this? Shit! Oh, man. We're just having fun today. Come on, keep on. Come on up here. You guys got sand in your eyes, or can you not see me? Well, he's just contemplating life over there. His friend is looking beyond the scope, so he can't really see anything. But this guy is just... Oh, now you decide. Do I need to make this easier for you? There. Was that so hard? Still can't strap a balloon to this. Oh well. Not my problem. Oh, these guys are coming too? Come on. Come say hi. I got enough for all of you. That's one. That's two. Reload. I'll take some of your materials, and I'll GTFO. Later, boys. I'm out. What you doing, guy? What you doing, guy? You want to get mowed down? Bam! And just for good measure. disable your connection. Yeah. Let's make sure we're reloaded.
Extraction arrived at mother base.
Oh, you want some too, String Bean? No, I didn't think so. How far do we have to leave? We just have to get out of this. Alright. Ooh, doggy. Now, obviously, it has said that my bond with D-Dog has decreased because he's gotten blown up twice. That typically happens with Tanner. But, to increase your affinity, if you will, with your, like, with D-Horse, with Quiet, with D-Dog, what I've learned through D-Horse is that you basically just take them on missions. The more missions that you complete and the less damage that they take, the more your bond with them goes through. They don't even have to participate in the mission. They just want to be taken there with you. So it's going to take a few missions on the side with D-Dog to get his bond up. But with that bond, it doesn't necessarily change anything. I mean, he does get, I think, a bark. Is what he gets? I believe he gets a bark. Or so, what can I do?
Didi.
Happy Alright, well, yeah, he gets a distraction mode or something like that. He gets a bark. Whereas with D-Horse, you you basically tell D-Horse, hey, go ahead and take a shit, and he takes a shit. It's comical, but also I've heard that you can, like, if enemy vehicles run over it, they slide, like they slip and slide and spin out on the turd like it's a Mario Kart banana. So that's great. Well, it looks like we have a few minutes left for this episode, so we're going to take a nice little sunny side jog through this lovely sandy wonderlandy. Over towards the next destination. Now, I was just going to be fine with it being two missions, but we have enough time, and the missions went quite successfully. A little mishap here and there with the landmine and the grenade, but yeah, that's fine. We took hits, but we're fine. And then I'll fly us out. We'll head to Mother Base, finish off the episode thusly. Wow, it's already 12 o'clock. It is noon. It's noon. God, this is taking. This is, like I said, this is one of the. A medicinal plant. Where is the medicinal plant? There they are. On the map, they're so close together, but in real life, they're just so far apart.
You have arrived at your destination.
Why you gotta make me work for it?
You have arrived at your destination.
I am. This is up on the mountaintop. Drop top mountaintop. Hear the rain go plop plop. Or whatever the fuck the song is. I don't know. Can we cut through the mountain? Is there a way to do that? Well, there was, but that takes a longer route, so I'm gonna say no. Oh, there's enemies up there, but I don't want to deal with them. I don't want to deal with that nonsense right now. Now, I'm going to try to keep the physical differences. I forgot I could do that. So, I forgot to mention that the character I'm playing as is just one of the combat deployment characters, as we've discussed with this whole thing. This character in particular has the perk Savage, which means that if I'm sprinting and I press right trigger, he does this awesome punch. Now, I can do the same punch as Big Boss when I have his arm equipped, and I think I can do this. Oh, yeah! Where you going, Sheepy? Where you going, Sheepy? So, I wonder... This says... What is this? Eliminate the heavy infantry. I wonder, for Tanner's sake, because I know he'd want to go with it, can we take down these guys with punches? And with D-Dog's help, we can find out their exact location. I feel like we can do this. I feel like we can take down these guys, because these guys have heavier armor than even I do. This is like Shiloh's shortened levels of armor. It's crazy. So, let's see.
Analysis.
All right. Analysis. Want the mark, complete. Jesus Christ. What?
Analysis complete.
What if I even mark? Oh, I marked that guy. Huh? Well, I don't see any heavy infantry. Those guys are all just regular Soviets. I bet you anything, they're probably going to be up there where I'm marked. Oh, that's just a bush. Excuse me, rock. Can I climb up this? Please tell me I can climb this. I can. Slowly but surely. Come on, D-Dog. What are you doing? Why are you over there? Okay, well, I guess D-Dog had to take the long route.
The map has been updated.
Oh, there you are. Maybe you took the easier route. I don't know. Aha! The targets have been spotted. Okay, so what we are going to do is... decoy. We are gonna set a little trap. Bam. Now, what the decoy does is it inflates a balloon that looks like a big boss. Looks like Venom Snake. So, what we're gonna do... Are these guys... Man, they're not even walking towards it. What are you guys doing? Come on. Set this trap up for you and not even gonna do it. All right, fine. Fine. You need to be careful. I don't want these guys. Okay, there's a rock right there. I don't want these guys turning around. What we're gonna do. We're gonna take, I don't know why I went straight. Yep.
Caution. Sandstorm approaching.
Somebody! Bam! Oh no! Oh no! Ah!
Ah! Ah! Oh dude!
Just throw him! Oh, fuck. Well, that went about as good as we could get it. We got one, we got two. There we go. We did it. Yeah! High five! Oh, shit! Oh, no. See, now we gotta move! Come on! I knew we'd get blown up in this freaking mission. I knew! Okay, we gotta get out of here. Hell of a chapter. Let's go! Oh no. They're still firing mortars even in the midst of a sandstorm. A Darud sandstorm. Oh gosh. Well, we did it. We completed the mission. I wasn't expecting the second punch to go off like that, but we managed. We did it. we were successful in our mission, and that's what counts. Good on us.
This is B-Quad. Arriving shortly at LZ.
Come on.
This is B-Quad. We can't land.
Oh, come on. Oh, I can't use my Phantom Cigar. You know what? Fuck this. I'll just wait out the storm. Oh, hey, I'm glad you guys could land now. Now, it doesn't show up as well, and I probably should have thought about this beforehand, but I actually changed the color of the chopper, and I changed the color of the, of Mother Nature. I also could have picked up those flowers, but fuck! Ain't about that life! Here's a decoy. Whoop! You see it? Yeah, nope.
Departing!
Oh well. We did it! Three successful missions. Now, we could have just taken out... We could have just taken out the elite soldiers. But I said, fuck it. We strapped balloons to their asses and flew them away. Oh man, we are just... It wasn't that noticeable, but... Oh man, we did take some hits, but we're good. We just shake it off. We're just gonna go ahead and return to Mother Base, because I want you to get. I think this will be a staple. I'll just take us back to Mother Base. You can get to see the. Oh, I got an achievement. Prosperity. Earned a total of 10 million GMP or more. Well, that's good. Oh, yeah, I got a cutscene. I don't know how this works. Oh, Who missed me?
Sorry. Been away a while, huh?
Don't be such a stranger. Such a bad example for the men. And he gets spoken to.
Oh.
Diddy, come.
Oh, they're good boy. Alright, see you, Ty.
Clear shortly.
Yeah, it's always so weird. Whenever you see a cutscene like that that involves snakes talking, it changes to that. But you're still playing as the other character, so it doesn't really make that much sense. Alright. Well, this has been really fun. Here, whoops. Let's end this properly. What? Okay, don't know why they're facing that way, but, fine. I guess we'll do it that way. Anyways, thank you guys so much for joining me. Tanner, I hope you enjoy this episode. It's all about you, buddy, the White Rocket. And, I'm Colonel Hammond, and until next time, hopefully we'll get these facing the right way. But until next time, you're dismissed. I'll see you guys in the next episode, all right?